We got a playoff-like atmosphere for this Western Conference Finals rematch last night, with Luka and Steph going back and forth until the very end. But the refs got involved and called what had to have been an all-time record for traveling violations, leaving us viewers to feel like every play was like... Let's quickly look at what Steph and Luka were doing to lead their respective teams. While the Giannis's and LeBron's of the league might be the most dominant scorers in transition, no one does it like Curry, forcing defenders to pick him up at half court or else. Luka continues to do real damage down low in the post, while the Warriors weren't committed to doubling him early in the game. Later, they flirted with some help, but wary of leaving a red-hot Hardaway open. They let Wiggins do it alone, good contest, but it's too close to the hoop for a guy like Luka. Meanwhile, they were taking turns demonstrating the proper way to hit step back and sidestep threes while going to their left, which is the easier way since their shooting hip and elbow are already aligned to the hoop. And while Steph easily gets the most amazing shot of the game award for this clutch jumper, it was Luka clearing Steph out of the way for the nifty turnaround fadeaway from 13 feet that gave the Mavericks just enough breathing room to hang on for dear life after they totally botched defending this well-designed play from Steve Kerr. Of course, it helps if Steph gets to be left tackle for possession, but Dallas still should have been switching everything and playing on the high side of the offense. But the real story of the game were the 11, count them, 11 dribbling violations they called in this game. So let's examine them all and see if the refs just seem to be picking on Jordan Poole and anyone around him, or if these calls are legit and a new era in NBA ball handling. In their constantly moving offense, it's not always easy to handle split-second decisions. As Klay comes off the handoff, now this is weird since he slightly lifts both feet in the air just after he catches the ball. But let's say he was in the air when he caught it. He puts the right foot down first, that's the pivot, then lifts it and puts it back down. They were willing to ignore this one though, accepting that his left foot was the pivot. However, he then slides that one before releasing the ball down into the dribble, and that is a walk. Klay flirts with another travel on this catch off the pin down, but Curry gets it back, the shot fake gets him into the lane, but watch Bullock stunt at him and then stay in the passing lane to the corner while Finney Smith perfectly splits the difference here, and Dinwiddie crashes down hard on Looney. There's nowhere to pass, and Curry has to land back on the ground with the ball for the violation. Jordan Poole seemed a bit too excited last night, unable to keep control of his immense speed and quickness. On the shot fake, he establishes the left foot as his pivot foot, then one dribble sidestep move ends with the left foot down as the gather, the right foot is the pivot, and he slides it ever so slightly a couple of inches. The ref is standing right there with a perfect view and has to make the call. And if you want to be right near the action so you can see all these traveling calls for yourself, then you have to download SeatGeek, the best app to find tickets to any sporting event, concert, or the theater. With just a few taps, SeatGeek will scour the internet for the best deals out there, giving them a grade so you know what kind of value you're getting. They're rated number one on Trustpilot amongst all major ticketers, so you can feel secure that your tickets are legit. Best of all, you can save $20 off your first purchase by using my code BBALL. So head over to SeatGeek now and you can enjoy all your favorite NBA teams live and in person, so you can see just how fast Poole is trying to play on this kickout. The left foot is established as a pivot with the shot fake, and with the negative step to load and drive, the front foot slides several inches forward. Again, right in front of the ref who's got a great view, and it's a no-brainer. This violation was covered in our last travel video on Jordan Poole, and remember, the rule is that the ball cannot touch both hands consecutively without it bouncing on the ground first. Luka passes the ball from right hand to left hand, then dribbles again, a simple call to make. Maybe there's something wrong with this part of the court, since Spencer Dinwiddie gets his feet all twisted up like Klay did earlier. First off, Luka is allowed some leeway once he falls to the floor as long as he doesn't move around too much, so no travel there, but Dinwiddie gets caught when he catches the ball with his left foot on the ground, then hops on that same left foot. The refs are usually great at catching this Yugo-step travel, and Dinwiddie would be wise to refrain from getting on the refs so much. Now, this one was a problem for the refs, and I get that sometimes strange-looking movement patterns can fool the eye, as Luka shortens his left step into the jump before passing the ball. But if you watch this one closely, you can see that the dribble ends with either the left foot down as the gather step, or you could even argue it's here with the right foot down. Then all he does is take one more step and lift into the air to pass. With either foot as the gather, it's a very legal play and an incorrect call. Don't forget, the refs get around 94% of all plays correct, and it's remarkable how much they see despite player congestion and angles that close up fast. Green picks the ball up and steps forward with the left foot, establishing the right foot as his pivot. He then picks that right foot up and puts it back down into the jump. That is illegal and a good traveling call. With everyone on the edge of their seat wondering when the next travel call would be made, it was Luka who got caught. He ends the dribble with the right foot down in a jab step. That means the left foot becomes the pivot. The great contest by Kuminga concerns Luka so much that he takes another small step with that pivot foot. A big no-no, and it was right in front of the ref. Perfect angle to see this and blow the whistle. Steph doesn't want to get left out of the conversation on anything, so he comes right back down, gets the ISO on the mismatch, and another great contest interrupts the flow of his step back. In college, referees are instructed to consider this a jump stop if the feet are close to landing simultaneously, but not in the NBA, as the replay shows he landed left, then right, which means he cannot lift the pivot and put it back down, which is exactly what he does for that left foot, a clear travel. Blow that whistle, rotate those arms around each other, and give the ball back to the Mavs. Sports fans, tonight, join me for a live watch party over on Playback. Just log in with your League Pass credentials beforehand, and now I can actually change channels and follow whatever game we want. It's really fun since there's a chat, live polls, you can come on the show and chop it up with me as well. Click the link in the description and I'll see you there. And then there was the big one. Down two, they quickly go into a pick and roll with Draymond. Kleba is almost hopeless with his positioning, but his late contest screws Steph up. The right foot jab step is the gather as he ends the dribble here. Now, had he landed on a jump stop with both feet at the same time, he'd have legally been allowed to pivot on either foot. But because the left foot clearly comes down first, he can only move the right foot if he wanted to. Instead, he lifts the left foot, puts it back down, and that seemed to be a fitting ending to a game where the ref's arms must have been tired from all the signaling, and when the NBA players finally figure out how to stop walking on sunshine, then it'll be